You went that way.
Jeez, mate. Summer students. Isn't showing them around the campus. They won't leave me alone.
I have the same problem, mate. It's to do with sweat. It gives off an erogenous odour. Women can't resist the pull of the pong.
Jules, you just stink.
Anything on?
That editor of the Post wants me to come up with another story.
About what?
Well, that's just it. Nothing's going on.
Off the grass, gentlemen.
There's your story. A mighty Quinn.
Quinn? Why?
Cassandra?
I'm busy, sorry. I haven't got time to stop.
But yesterday...
I'll try and see you later.
You okay?
Can I help you?
I had to get these filled in by the summer students. You needed them back?
Oh, thanks, Alan. I'll pass them on.
If you're not too busy, I would like those acceptance letters sometime today.
Do you want me to give you a hand?
Oh, no. You better not. Mr. Quinn finds out and he won't like it.
Right. You know, you don't have to put up with that kind of treatment.
Well, I want to keep my job.
Is it worth it?
Do this, do that. He never gives me a break. And I try so hard to keep on top of things, but there's always so much to do, you know?
You should stand...
Playing statues, Mr. Hollins?
Had curry last night. Come in.
Earlier, what were you going to say about Quinn?
Who? Oh, him. Heard something about Mrs. Wilcox. You know the one, ginger hair, big thighs.
What about her?
She told him off for shouting to one of the cleaners. That man likes the sound of his own voice. What makes him tick? There's your story.
He's a bully, there's my story. I've just seen it. He had Miss Lake in tears.
And Miss Lake, she's nice. A bit plain, but nice. She married.
Jules, we're talking about Quinn.
Oh, just chill out, mate. Enjoy the holidays. I know I like spending mine.
Miss Lake?
Hi. Are you okay? Come in. Mr. Quinn's seen someone in accounts. It's Catherine, by the way.
Jack. Listen, about earlier, what you were telling me?
Oh, no, forget that.
Does he bully the other staff?
Some, yeah.
Who?
It'll only get them into trouble.
That's how bullies thrive, on the fear of their victims. Listen, I'm thinking about writing an article on bullying for the Pulse. I want your help.
Have you written for the student newspaper before?
I've just had an article published. It came out really well. I'd like to do some more.
I'm sure you're very good. It's just, you know, if you mess this up, then my job's on the line.
I won't. I know what I'm doing.
Well, Mr. Quinn will know it's me who's talked about him.
I never reveal my sources. No one will ever know. I'll talk to your colleagues. You'll be one of many. Besides, you've done nothing wrong.
Okay, well, what do you want to know?
Tell me how it is. What it's like working for Quinn.
He's a pig. I dread coming in some days.
And is that how Mrs. Wilcox felt? She in?
Sick leave. Stress. Mr. Quinn's constant shouting must have got to her. Does after a while. It makes our lives a misery.
I'd really like to talk to her, get her side of the story.
If I give you a phone number, then don't say you got it from me.
No way, you have my word.
Well, her number's just in my diary, so... Excuse me. Jack, look, I don't feel right about this. I don't want to make things any worse, and I'm not sure I should give you Sally's number.
Well, you have to stop protecting him.
Well, I'm not. Look, he normally switches this off.
It's okay, I'll leave you to it.
Well, I thought you wanted an interview.
You've given me plenty for now.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night.
Jules!
Tonight's gonna be a good night. Tonight's gonna be a good, good night.
Jules!
What's this?
Private file from Quinn's office.
You like your head, what you do with that?
It was in his room and I just read it. Take a look. Uni printout from last year. It lists applicants' grades and admissions.
I don't want to know, man.
Some of these students haven't got the grades to get onto the course.
It's a tough life.
So, why have they been accepted? Quinn's head of admissions, he accepts or rejects every student. He's letting some in when he shouldn't. And that's not all, I saw his computer. He's doing it again this year.
Maybe he's in a good mood.
Use your head. He's taking bungs. Quinn's at it.
What are you going to do?
Why did you rush off earlier?
I was busy. Yesterday, I shouldn't have... I've never done anything like that before. You're a patient. If you want to make a complaint, I quite understand.
Complaint about what? If you must know, I was incredibly flattered that someone so young would want to spend time with me.
Maybe I should ask another nurse to see you from now on.
Yesterday was a brief aberration on both our parts, never to be repeated. Let's not say another word.
The interview will only take about 20 minutes, if that.
And you say this article is for The Pulse?
That's right. It's going to be about you, your job, how things are done in the admissions department, that kind of thing. A sort of a day in the life.
I really am very short of time, Mr. Hollins. Couldn't this wait?
I thought we could get it in for the start of term. Mr. Quinn, I think your department gets overlooked. A lot of students would be very interested in your selection procedures.
Well, I don't see why not. I'm sure I can find the time.
Great.
Now, I must say, my days are normally filled with mundane paperwork. They're not exactly full of action.
You're a lot more interesting than you think. How long have you worked here?
17 years.
Long time.
Fortunately, I enjoy my work.
How much do you get paid?
Not an appropriate question, Mr. Hollins.
Students really look up to you.
One does one's best to set a good example.
You're one of the most powerful men in the uni.
Nonsense.
So, would you say you get on with your staff?
Yes, on the whole.
So, you don't have any problems with staff relationships?
What relationships?
There have been some unofficial complaints about the way you talk to people. It's only fair that you have your chance to put across your side of the story.
Complaints? About what?
Bullying.
I have never heard anything so preposterous.
And that's not all, Mr. Hollins. Something else, something far more serious has come to my attention.
Enough, Mr. Hollins.
As head of admissions, you rubber stamp all of our applications. Without your approval, none of us would be here. Is that correct?
Yes. And this interview is now terminated.
Well, I've not finished.
But I have. Now out, Mr. Hollins. Out!
I'm grabbing lunch from the Icon. Julia and Ruth have put in their orders. You two?
Actually, I was just going over there myself.
Jimmy could save you the bother.
It's all right. I fancy a walk.
I bet you do.
You ready?
Yeah.
I'm working on another story.
Are you now?
Why'd you say it like that?
No reason. Well, I mean, Don't get me wrong, we are all proud of your Houseman article, but you're doing a law degree, not journalism.
I'm good at it.
Oh, I'm so modest.
It's about corruption at this uni, real meaty stuff. Forget student mag, this could be in the nationals. I need to do a bit more digging.
Well, good luck with that.
Must be a lot of bullying in the police service. What?
If you carry on at this rate, I'm going to have to watch everything I say.
Just taking an interest in my dad's work.
Pull the other one. Jack the Hack.
Remind me, which leg is it again? If your heart can withstand that, you're in pretty good shape.
Is that supposed to perk me up?
Ah. There we are. Keep you in good spirits. Oh, I never thought of you as a malingerer, so what are you still here for?
My BP's high.
Not surprising. And that's all it is.
That and the indisputable fact that Ravi takes great pleasure in seeing me propped up in bed while he plays God.
Now, for someone with high blood pressure, you're getting a little bit worked up. I'm going to go and have a word with him.
No way. I've got to put this file back. I don't want to print out this year's results. The uni's got its own software. You're always saying that you can hack into any computer. Now's your chance to prove it. Quinn's gone to lunch. Come on. I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. This one's still on. I'll see you in the network. Good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Tonight's the night. Let's live it up. I got my money. Let's spin it up. Go out and smash it. Mr. Johnson.
Bins are not for decoration. Good afternoon, ladies.
No running along the corridors, thank you.
Fill up my cup, mazel tov. Look at her dancing. Just take it off. Let's paint the town. We'll shut it down. Let's burn the roof, and then we'll do it again. Let's do it, let's do it, let's do it, let's do it, and do it, and do it. Let's live it up and do it, and do it, and do it, do it, do it.
What the hell are you doing? I'm a thief. And you a law student, Mr. Hollins.
Hey, that's mine.
Disgraceful.
Give me back my bag.
Police, please.
Yes. Oh. How did Mr. Nuffle get a pea stuck in his ear?
Oh, I don't know. I wonder if it still counts towards when you're 5 a day.
Knowing him, it probably smells like gravy on it.
Oh. So I had a patient once who thought his hand was a puppet.
No. Did you talk to it?
Oh, I gave it a prescription.
You're making a big mistake.
I'll ask again. What was it you were hoping to find?
I'm not a thief.
Tell that to the police. You were caught red-handed.
Just like you've been.
Someone said something to you.
I can't answer that.
Is this to do with Catherine?
And the rest. Let's just say I know what you've been up to.
She's told you, hasn't she?
Afternoon, sir. Sergeant Hollins. What are you doing here?
I'm
terribly sorry, officer. I've made a dreadful mistake. Hollins, you say?
He's my dad.
Does somebody want to tell me what's going on?
I'd given Jack permission to look for something in my office, and I'd forgotten all about it. What with all the admissions this time of year, I'm really sorry to have wasted your time, Sergeant.
That's okay, sir, as long as you're happy with that. We'll leave it. Jack, a word. Thank you, sir. What was all that about?
Nothing.
So why were you in his office?
Just like he said, I had his permission.
Yeah, I heard what he said. Listen, if this has got anything to do with that story you were banging on about...
Dad, trust me. I know what I'm doing.
Trust you? Now I know you're up to something.
I'm investigating a story. If I happen to uncover things that people are trying to hide, well, that's their hard luck.
Yeah, and if you break the law, it's yours.
Taking ages.
You could always sit here, have a lunch here.
Yeah. No, I can't. Julia's panini will get cold.
Hypothermia in Julia's panini.
Cheers, mate. Thanks. You okay?
Yeah. Dr. Carter, did I leave my pen here?
Not that I've seen. Please, call me Hester.
Maybe it's best not to be too familiar.
Nonsense. Look, you've been working hard all day. You could do with a few minutes rest. Why do you feel so guilty?
My behaviour was unprofessional.
You're the best tonic a patient could have.
But you're not just any patient. My parents always taught me that I must be truthful and I...
What?
We have so many interests in common. I was...
Yes?
I feel so comfortable with you. I want to be with you. And that sounds so immature. I'm sorry, this must embarrass you.
Not at all. I find your honesty touching. Cassandra, you must realise that in an environment like this, this sort of thing often happens.
You think it's just a young girl's crush?
No, of course not.
I feel that we're soulmates. There, I've said it. Can you deny that you have feelings for me?
She could give me a bed bath any day.
Is that all you can think about? She wouldn't give you a second look in a million years.
Protective, eh?
Sorry. Life takes unexpected twists.
Start at the beginning.
What did you say?
Thief of dunce, more like.
Hey, get off him! Coward!
You all right?
I think so. All I did was ask him if his parents had paid Quinn to get him on the course.
You did what? Are you stupid or something?
No, but he is.
I left my bag in Quinn's office. And why didn't you tell me he was back before legging it?
I tried, but it was too late. I hid and ran when his back was turned.
What happened? He called the cops. My dad turned up.
No!
Did you get anything from Catherine's computer?
Big fat nothing. You?
Same. I'm gonna have to run it with what I got.
What? Some dodgy printouts? Not much by way of evidence, is it?
You're sounding like a lawyer.
What proof have you got that Quinn's taking bribes?
Quinn's head of admissions. It was his file. It was on his desk. Why else would he be accepting students who'd failed their entry requirements? Money, cash, wonga. Why else?
It's not enough.
It's have to be.
You've got your mole on the inside. Use her.
Catherine?
Bit of sweet talking. Bit of the old Hollands charm. Put it in your hands, mate. Nice.
Oh! I have just made a complete fool of myself. It was all going so well, and then the moustache. It was awful. It was off before it was even on. I've only got myself to blame. I was trying to be all confident, and I just came across as a complete idiot. Funny, ha ha. Simon? Oh, forget it.
She's a sweet girl, but I don't want to hurt her feelings. She's too young.
She's old enough to know what she wants.
She's my nurse. It's inappropriate.
Well, a pretty young thing like that would
you? Yeah, we know what you'd do.
Look, some people are going to tut-tut about the age difference. She might get a slap on the wrist from Matron. Who cares? You're both single. You're not hurting anybody. And for some unfathomable reason, she seems to fancy you. So, you'd be mad to let us slip through your fingers.
It wouldn't be right.
So what? At our age, chance like that? Oh, I had a chat with Ravi. He's going to discharge you.
I thought we'd agreed it would stay between us.
It has.
What's that boy looking for?
How would I know?
You were talking to him this morning.
You sound jealous.
I won't change my mind.
Well, it'd be too late now, even if you did. Drink your coffee, Mr. Quinn, while it's still hot. And not too many biscuits. Your wife won't like it.
You're enjoying this?
Enjoying what, Mr. Quinn?
What have you been saying?
Nothing. Why would I?
I'm sick of your nasty little...
Leave her alone! Oh, look. It's Carl Woodward, Jr.
He's found out about me talking to you. He's going to sack me.
Catherine, you're making matters worse.
Can't sack you for exposing him.
I knew you told him. You vindictive.
Why wouldn't she?
It was a moment's weakness.
Weakness? What, taking bribes? For accepting students without sufficient academic qualifications? I call that greed.
Bribes?
Well, don't deny it. I've seen the evidence. And you've been messing about with this year's intake. I've seen the list on your computer.
Catherine.
Don't look at me.
You've been accepting students who've had rubbish grades, and there can only be one reason. Money.
Judge, jury and executioner.
And on top of that, you're a bully.
Prove to me you are not as stupid as you look, Mr. Hollins. Is my wife the next on your hit list?
Please, Mr. Quinn, you're scaring me.
What's this got to do with your wife? Are you two?
Once. And only the once. And she has made me suffer ever since.
You shouldn't have pretended you loved me then.
I never said I loved you. Every day, she threatens to tell my wife. Even makes remarks in front of the other staff. But this...
Are you saying she set you up?
I have never accepted a student without the minimum entry requirements.
But the file, your computer... I didn't catch him at it. I caught you at it.
You're not that clever. You saw what I wanted you to see.
What's your game?
Last year, I let one student bypass the system. Well, the grateful parents gave me enough money to pay me rent for 6 months. Word got around and I couldn't refuse.
You used me to frame Mr. Quinn.
It was easy. And if you think I'm going to admit to anything, you can think again. It's all been done on your computer and in your name.
Catherine, please.
It's payback time, Mr. Quinn.
I've got a witness.
Oh. Well, you broke into your office and then you lied to a police officer about it.
I won't get away with this.
Last year, I let one student bypass the system. Well, the grateful parents gave me enough money to pay me rent for 6 months.
Thank you, Mr. Hollins.
Preston.
You got your scoop, then?
Not the one I thought I had.
Still a story.
I had the wrong person. Could have ruined him. She took me for a ride.
Lessons in life, lad.
Quinn would have been suspended wrongly, and I'd be thinking how clever I am, crowing about it. Jack the Hack, it's pathetic.
Don't be so hard on yourself.
Hey, mate, I wouldn't hang around if I were you.
Why, what's up?
Still got his fans, then.
Back in there. Give me your phone number.
No, it's best this way.
Who for? What's your problem? You both think the same way. You like the same things. She even considers you to be a soulmate. You're going to walk away from such a rare creature.
I can do it!
Because it's a law.
His name is Mr. Galifianakis. He's a new chief executive of the PCT.
Mr. Galifianakis? Good morning.
I mean, how can you look into an animal's eyes and then wantonly mutilate and murder it and kill it?
Oh, my God, forgot us if I let Daniel do it.
There's no business like show business, a double murder mystery.